the novena in honor of St. Thorlak of Iceland. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the holy life and example of St. Thorlak of Iceland. Inspired at the youngest age to seek wisdom, he found it in you, in the Psalms and writings of Holy Scripture, in the virtuous instruction of the priests who fostered him, and in the majestic natural wonders of his homeland. Receiving holy orders at 18, Thorlak devoted his entire life to feeding the spiritual and material hunger of his people. His quiet compassion for the poor and suffering led him to long hours of prayer on their behalf. He afforded peasants and penitents the same dignity he showed chieftains and kings. May St. Thorlak help us live and to love according to your will. Amen. St. Thorlak, quietly humble and pure of heart, pray for us. St. Thorlak, mentor in wisdom, pray for us. St. Thorlak, gentle pastor, pray for us. St. Thorlak, merciful confessor, pray for us. St. Thorlak, champion of families and holy matrimony, pray for us. St. Thorlak, defender of authentic Catholic living in all states of life, pray for us. St. Thorlak, fatherly intercessor, pray for us. St. Thorlak, true ambassador for Christ, pray for us. St. Thorlak, devoted patron of Iceland, pray for us. Heavenly Father, we pray that all people in Iceland may be united in Christ under the patronage of your holy servant, St. Thorlak. May all taste your unending love and mercy and rejoice in your presence. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The Novena in honor of St. Thorlak of Iceland. Day 6. St. Thorlak, defender of authentic Catholic living in all states in life. St. Thorlak lived in a time of great contrast. He grew up in a country populated by poor farmers and seafarers, frequently subject to harsh climatic conditions and fluctuations in the availability of food. He himself came from a family in good social standing whose money ran out during a downturn in mercantile activity. And, from complete poverty, he then entered the high social class of the priesthood. He went from being self-taught to attending a prestigious center of learning, and he studied abroad, only to return home to his humble roots. In his religious career, he was a deacon, a parish priest, a theological scholar, a canon regular of the Order of St. Augustine, a consecrated abbot of a monastery, and bishop. In each setting, St. Thorlak conducted himself as he did anywhere else, in full obedience to God. Historical narratives state that he heeded to the utmost the obligations which pertained to each of the ordinations he received. And as quickly as his education and ordination proceeded, he foresightedly attained with resolute steadfastness all the good qualities which belong to the orders. St. Thorlak never took his rank lightly, and felt the higher one rose, the greater his responsibility to live uprightly. In particular, he believed those in public offices had the greatest burden of good living as examples for all to see. Of the matters which troubled him, he particularly disliked attending proceedings at the Althing, Iceland's parliamentary gathering, as many men who were highly thought of went astray in their suits there. Likewise, he held the conviction that it is the greater downfall of the church if noble men err greatly. St. Thorlak tended many different walks of life among his flocks, peasants, married, single, prominent leaders, monks, and fellow priests. He saw them all equally as brothers and sisters in Christ, and expected no less from them. Let us pray. Almighty God, we sometimes find ourselves setting different standards based on different states in life. Help us to see, as St. Thorlak did, that we all share the same fundamental vocation, to love the Lord our God with all our hearts, all our souls, all our minds, and all our strength, and to love our neighbors as ourselves. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.